Hello, my fellow overindulged aspirins, I'm Mr. Church. Have you ever been building a camp for 72 hours so that you can show it off to your significant other when they come home from work so they can look at it for 12 seconds and say, oh, that's cool, and move on because they don't get what you've done? And something gets stuck and you just can't get it out, and you're filled with so much rage that you walk to someone's house unannounced and throw your meat at them while they stand there AFK. I know you've been there. And so today I thought I'd pile together in a compile way a list of things that I know get stuck, and maybe I can help show how to get that stuff unstuck. So I've compiled as much stuff as I could think of, and we'll go through the list and try not to clench your butt cheeks too much with rage. The first thing is the most common that happens, and that is when stairs get stuck or upper floors get stuck and there's no support. So stairs, upper floors, and foundations, they all need legitimate support in order for you to remove or move the things that are attached to them that need support. So this doesn't have a foundation underneath it, so the stairs can't be removed. This can happen quite a bit, especially if you're newer to the game and unfamiliar with the unnecessary building restrictions that we're suffering with. So the best way to go about this, if you can't get a foundation underneath the stairs, is to kind of make a M.C. Escher type structure with stairs and platforms going all over the place with no cohesion, so that you can find a place where the ground is lower and you can get the foundation into place. Now this can happen even if you've got a foundation into place, but it was still too low. Sometimes the game won't register that as legitimate support, so it still won't let you. So you still might need to do this. And in that case, what you're gonna wanna do is be careful when you place these down, because all of these stairs and upper floors right now are not deletable until we get a foundation in place. So be mindful of when you're building willy-nilly that you're not taking up the only available remaining space within your camp boundary, because you don't want to have to place your camp and move everything all over again. You don't need to turn stuff into mesh floors. That had no reason for happening. So once you can get to a lower place that you can put the foundation down, you'll be able to go all the way back to the beginning and in a backwards manner delete stuff as you go. All upper floors, stairs, and foundations that do not have legitimate support will follow these same rules where they need to go back to a legitimate support. So I'll go over the foundations and stuff later on, but this can also happen if you're working with catwalks, because catwalks are magical and they allow us to do a lot of things, but the reason for that is because they don't count towards support. So they don't carry the support for this upper floor all the way back through here. It breaks the support. So these two things are stuck together and they're technically floating. They don't have support because the catwalks don't count. If you need to edit stuff and you have catwalks like this, just simply remove the catwalks and they'll just pop right out because they don't need support again. And then you can just replace where the catwalks are temporarily with upper floors until you can snap back to where the stair is. And that will make this be the support for that. So everything goes back towards that way, and you can delete backwards till you're able to start over from whatever you were trying to do. Now the next thing that can happen is when you're using stair gantries. Now these things are weird and annoying. They used to be even worse, and they've slightly helped fix them. But first of all, you can't put walls around them unless you walk up to them and hang your head in shame, which you probably will be doing anyway because you're building in Fallout 76. And for some reason, that will then let you place walls around these. Now for whatever reason, even though these are doorways which float and don't need support, and even though there is support in here, foundations, when you go to remove this stair gantry with walls on it, it simply won't let you. It will say that part of the structure would not be accessible, and that of course makes no sense. This isn't really any game mechanic that makes any sense to me. This is probably just one of, you know, the thousands of bugs that will never become fixed because it's part of the canon and the lore of the game, you know? So, basically, to demonstrate how stupid this is, if I have these doorways over here, I can remove the foundation. They don't need support. So, for these walls to be the reason why these stairs can't come out makes no sense. But, if this happens to you, just get rid of these doorways or walls or whatever you have there, and then you'll be able to get rid of that stair gantry for no reason. That's great. Thank you, Bethesda. Now, the next thing that can get stuck together that I thought of are walls. Now, this can happen with full walls or half walls, but if you don't have a foundation underneath them for legitimate support, two stacked half walls are going to be sketchy. Now, the easiest way to break that need for support is to burn one of these walls, and that removes the support requirement for it, so the other one will be deletable. Now, if you don't have the ability to destroy one of these walls, there's a couple of ways that you can still give it support. And so in this case, I don't have the flamethrower trap on this character, and I have two walls that are stuck together. Even though that's a doorway, it won't let me delete it, but I can put these perimeter railings with the stairs, and those will give me support for me to delete backwards towards this. And I can also use roofs to give support. So if I have these walls stuck together like this, I can then go over. I can't put a foundation in, it's too low. So what I'm gonna do is I want to go over by two foundations in width using these catwalks, because catwalks are awesome and they'll let you snap downward. So we're gonna snap a half floor there. You can of course get rid of the catwalks and put a roof in across here. But actually you wanna put the, see, we're gonna put a foundation here. You're gonna need to put the foundation in first because of this roof here. It's just a build order thing, don't worry about it. But once you have these roofs up here snapped together, the support goes from this foundation through the roof all the way back to here, and you can delete those roofs and then everything in a backwards manner. And it makes perfect sense. Now, on that note, roofs can be tricky, but if you ever have a roof and it's locked up and you can't delete it, this usually means that a roof next to it is giving it support. Now, to make it not need support anymore, you just take the roof that's giving support, which in this case is this one, and you can replace it with any of these shapey ones, and that'll let you delete it. So if you ever need a roof standing alone, or if you have a roof that's locked up, try doing that to the one next to it, and that should free your roof so that you can delete it. And I'll show you again here. Let's say you have some roofs like this, and for whatever reason, you want to delete this one. And if I try to do that, that's holding that roof up. So if I want to do that, I just replace it with a flat or a corner piece, and then I can just get rid of it. And this can be useful if you want to make floors out of roofs, or if you just have one in a weird place and it's all locked up. Now let's talk about ramps for a second. Ramps are weird when you have walls on top of them because they'll hog the support. So in this case, I should be able to delete this ramp because that wall is on the foundation, right? You can see it's on that side of it, facing that way. And I can't get rid of the foundation because it's holding up the wall. But I also can't get rid of the ramp because that too is holding up the wall, even though if I have two foundations next to each other in the same place with a wall, I will be able to delete this foundation here, no problem. But ramps hog foundation or hog support, which is kind of how Todd Howard hogs the support of Fallout 76 by making them all go work on Starfield so nothing gets fixed. Now, if you change this to a doorway, you can actually delete the ramp out of there because it no longer needs support because it's a doorway, and doorways are beautiful and lovely creatures that are unbound by the restraints of the time. Now, if you have a half wall up here, you'll have the same issue. And if for some reason you can't get rid of the half wall, but you want to get rid of the ramp, the roof method won't work because the ramp is just too greedy with support. It just hogs it all. It's just absolutely despicable. So what you're going to do is you're going to have to destroy that half wall there, which will remove its need for support. Now, if you ever want to remove the need for support, just play Fallout 76, because we don't need it anyway. I kind of like how everything is broken, because it lets us, you know, fast travel sometimes, never. I don't like fast traveling. I hate it. It's dumb because then you can go places. So if you have a object in your camp that gets all glitched out, so it's a solid object, this can happen sometimes. You can even make it happen on purpose for other nefarious reasons, and I'll link a video if you want to go check out what you could possibly want to do that for. But if this happens on accident and you want to get rid of it, unfortunately, your only option really is to leave the server, because this is now a world object to you. It is not bound to the camp. If I switch camps right now, that cappy rug is still going to be there. And the one I was standing on is gone, but, you know, this one's here. And other people in the world won't see this. That's just a cappy for you. And that's not what anyone asked for. So just leave the server. Go to a different one if you want to. And if you come back, you'll see the camp is loaded in. I've got the one cappy rug there, but the one that was glitched out is gone. It's just a weird visual glitch. Let's get rid of that. Okay, we're good. Can't see that anymore. Now, other objects can get stuck under the map sometimes. And in this case, I have a staircase under there that is keeping me from being able to delete this foundation. But you can also get decorations and camp objects stuck under the map sometimes. And this is a good way to see. If you look up in the air in third person, you can enter camera mode and you can look under the map and see if your stuff is stuck down there. Now, to get it, the best way is to probably just go under the map and grab it. So I'm going to show you how to do that real quick, if you're not sure how. But this can happen if you place stuff in world objects as well. It doesn't just mean stuff that's stuck under the map, but perhaps if you are in the mire, for example, they have those trees with the roots that kind of spread out at the bottom. You can sometimes place stuff in there, and then as soon as it's in there, you can't grab it anymore. But if you do this, and you make this little weird thing that I'm doing here, and you can use the symptomatic instead of this alien bed if you don't have the alien bed, but this will allow you to go under the map, and this will let you, you can actually position yourself so you can get up under that and grab it out. Now, I changed these rugs because the weird rush mat, they changed the hitbox on it, so it's way smaller. So it's way harder to grab the edge of that rush mat now, so it's harder to do the sinking glitch, but the cappy one is like coming towards me every time I pick it up, which is more frustrating than watching his Pinocchio nose sinking into his face. But eventually, with time and patience and aggression that I've barely repressed, must have gotten a text there because I just stopped doing everything. And you know how important it is to check your texts from, that weird symbol-y person that keeps sending you spam for no reason. And the reason is actually because someone leaked your phone number, and so now you get a bunch of spam. But that's okay, because spam is, well, it's not really meat, but you can still eat it if you're a vegetarian and get that protein. You know what I mean? Don't eat spam if you're a vegetarian. Don't eat it if you're not a vegetarian either. Just because you don't know where it's been. Now, as you can see, I'm able to get under the map here, grab the stuff that's stuck, and I can get that out of there, and it's beautiful, and my life has become complete. Well, no, it hasn't. I'm standing here playing Fallout 76, but sometimes you can get stuff stuck if you place it too close to the edge of a foundation. Now, foundations have these massive hitboxes on the sides of them so that your character and so that NPCs can walk up the side of them. If that happens, sometimes you can just rotate the foundation if you need to move it or pick it up, and then you can get to that. And that can happen sometimes. Sometimes you just have to pick up the foundation stuff is stuck on and store it if you place something on the side of it. Now here I'm going to talk about ramps a little bit more. Sometimes you can get foundations stuck up in the air too high if you're using a ramp. See, this is how high the ramp can go, or the foundation can go on its own, and as you can see, it's much higher with the use of the ramp. Now, when a ramp is used in this way, it acts the same way as a foundation and a staircase, meaning this is the support, and this is kind of the upper floor of it. So, if you wanted to get rid of this stuff, you'd have to work your way backward from the furthest out back towards the ramp, because the ramp is the support for these things. It's the same with normal foundations. If you built into the side of a hill, this is all kind of obvious stuff, but I did want to cover it in this video. Just if you're newer to the game, maybe you're not sure about it. There's a lot of weird stuff with how the camp building system works, but as you can see, this is now the support for all those foundations, and I can get rid of the ramp if I wanted, because now it's built into the side of a hill, so this one is the lowest one, and it's in the ground enough for that to be the support of the other stuff, which means I can't delete it until I get rid of the other foundations in this order, going back to this one. This is, like I said, kind of obvious, but I wanted this video to be as comprehensive as possible, and so I cover that as well. Now, sometimes you can get two foundations stuck together in the air that have no support anywhere, and they are stuck together. You can't move them or delete them, and if you stick other foundations to them, or upper floors and stairs, that stuff as well will become stuck. It'll all lock up in this one mushy mush fuck pile. So this is bad, and some camps can be destroyed this way, and you don't have to worry anymore because Papa Church is here to... No, just forget I said that. But anyway, the upper floor here is stuck and the stairs are stuck. This is all stuck because there's no legitimate support on this structure. These foundations are way too high in the air. Now, if you're in a terrain that allows for it, you could build over with foundations till you got to a hillside or something, so the foundation wouldn't be too high in the air. But if you're on flat ground, you can just use these ramps, because right here is the new foundation line, meaning this all has support now, and I can get rid of this stuff and get it out of my camp and never see it again. Sometimes that can be helpful if the terrain doesn't allow for you to build a foundation over somewhere to help you get out of that sticky situation. Now, the same thing can happen if somehow you get your foundations too low in the ground as well. Now, this one I could not replicate for this video, but I've had it happen before, because it's very inconsistent and it all depends on the terrain you're working with, because in this case, it's letting me build them really low into the ground and it does count as support, so I can move all these foundations around. But if they're locked up and they're that low, again, just use the ramp to come up a little bit to where you can have a foundation giving support to the foundations that are too low in the ground. Sometimes, and this is a very specific scenario that can occur, your foundations will get stuck together when you use certain blueprints. And I believe this is happening when foundations are flipped together instead of snapped together. So it kind of confuses the fuck out of the game. So what you're going to do in this situation, this one's very simple, and here's another example of it. I think I had to switch because I got attacked while I was building, and it destroyed my footage, and I got blood everywhere, and it ruined my vibe. So over here, I've built it again. This is, again, the bay window blueprint, but other ones will do it as well if they flip foundations toward each other or into each other. And they're stuck together And this one's even simpler. You just put another foundation on it, and it kind of breaks it out of that weird lockup that it's in. And I think this is using a similar mechanic as when you have these foundation stairs, or any foundation stairs, stuck to a foundation. For some reason, if you add another foundation to it, whether it's to the side or to the back, you can then delete this and the stair can be free. That's not really a stuck situation. It's more of a just a thing you can do if you want to get those stairs on their own. Now, the last thing I want to talk about in this video of stuff that can get stuck is when you're building in bad boy water. Now, bad boy water is water that when you place something in it, you can never access it again. Now, all the water in the game isn't like this, only bad boy water is, and it's very random which water you're building in. Because there's all kinds of bad boy water all up and down the Savage Divide, but sometimes you'll find good boy water too, and all over the map. And, oh, let's Moonshine Jamboree, ADHD, and so, anyway, I found a spot that has both good and bad boy water, so you can see the difference. Now, it happens to be raining, so that's really helping me out here. But as you can see, on the left, you have good boy water, and there's ripples in the water when it rains, and on the right, there's bad boy water. It doesn't have ripples when it rains, and as soon as you place something in it, if it's a millimeter under the ground, I can't grab it anymore. But I can pick up stuff in good boy water all day long. So, as you can see, I can still grab that if I'm grabbing the huge hitbox that's in the good boy water side, but everything on the bad boy water side, I just can't pick it up. So, as you can see, it's just not good because it's bad boy water. So, you can't fix bad boy water if you have stuff in bad boy water. You have to move your whole camp to get it again. Now, I'm not going to say bad boy water again, I've said it too much, but my only advice is before you build in water, test the waters, as they say in the Bible, or whatever, to see if it's bad or not. And that's really all you can do about it. And the ripples are a good indication, but just test before you build, just to make sure. That's all I have for today. Thank you so much to my patrons for your support. Thank you to my channel members as well. If you're not already subscribed, consider subscribing. It really helps the channel grow. And if you're not, please join my Discord. It's a great community. And follow me on Twitch if you want to see me live, because I'm a lot more stupid in real time. I'll see you guys in the next video.